excited we are by giving a louder, louder round of applause.
So I'm not feeling the excitement. We just started this. It has to be louder, guys.
Performances from Bala to Shubh Mangal Savdhan to Toilet, Ek Prem Katha, and many more. Ladies and gentlemen, she also happens to be an advocate for climate change, a climate warrior. She's also been roped in by MTV to create awareness about health issues amongst the youth. So this one does a lot of things, all right? But one important question for you, Rumi. You're an actor, which means crazy work schedules and crazy work hours. How do you take care of health? Tell us your top three healthy habits.
I think, you have to be physically fit to be mentally fit, and I think my job requires a balance between both, right? So for starters, it has to start off with at least a 40-minute workout every day, and that's purely because that's my me time. It's literally meditative to me, and it's the time I literally breathe, do most of my thinking, and it can also be 3 in the morning, but I make sure that I start my day with a workout. And actually that's something I picked up from Akshay sir, because this is something that he does, he's been doing for years, and that really inspired me. I think the second thing that I really do is just eating clean, you know, just eat wholesome organic food, eat clean, and it really, once the moment you go onto the path of eating clean, you never want to eat food that makes you uncomfortable. And I think the third thing is just be happy. There's nothing that there can't be a bigger medicine than happiness in life. Just be positive, be happy, meditate. Yeah, so these are my three mantras in life.
All right,
so 40-minute workout, be it at 3 a.m. Did I hear it right?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
All right, a 40-minute workout and then eating clean and meditation.
Anything that you love. You could paint, you could read a book. It has to be something that gives you happiness. A way that you kind of disconnect from your everyday ruckus, right? Your phone, your television, everything that you hear. It's so important to just have some me time.
All right, so those are Bhumi Pednekar's way of staying healthy amongst all the madness and the crazy schedules that she has to adhere to. Moving on, in our Annapurna Masterclass, ladies and gentlemen, it's too formal. So my friends, we have over here with us none other than celebrity chef. He's also called the Prince of Chocolates.
Oh.
And he also happened to make that 6 feet tall chocolate Ganesha statue, right? Woo. The life-size edible mannequin, the only one on television. I'm so happy to introduce to you none other than Chef Varun Inamdar. Come on. Varun, we are going to be baking a blockbuster,
yes.
Is that right?
We have one of the finest actors in town.
And one of the finest chefs in Asia Pacific.
Yeah. Why not cook a blockbuster? Like that's the least we can do, right?
Absolutely.
Varun, I'm the MC, I love asking questions. I'll not let you go without that. So quick one. Give me one go-to dish of yours that can be made in a microwave oven with like the push of a button, just like that.
A brownie? A cake? You know, in fact, we have a lot of myths about a lot of complex looking things. We think they're very difficult, but actually they're not. You know, we just have to, like she says, you have to be physically fit, mentally fit and all of that. It's all that game. So she's actually hit it right there, where it's all about being physically fit, mentally fit. When so mentally there, you can crack any dish. You don't need a recipe, you don't need measurements, you don't need details. You just need to know what you want.
And love for food.
And love for food. Simple. That just like takes it off.
That is true. So friends, I'm going to move out of picture right now. Please don't forget the Start a Healthy Habit contest with Bhumi Pednekar. How she inspired you to take up a healthy living, a healthy habit. And now we are going to move on to our first masterclass, Annapurna, about nothing other than food. And we are going to be making a blockbuster with Bhumi and Chef Varun. Here we go.
I'm so excited.
Come. not really. Oh.
Good. Are you taking the cue?
Yeah, I'm taking
it. I see some really learn something very exciting today.
That's the point of that, yeah. So, but before we kind of get back to the cake, because now they've already realized and understood that this is not going to go beyond 5 minutes. Right? It's literally 2 minutes of mixing and 3 minutes of cooking.
Mm-hmm.
So we can
talk. We need to talk.
So the first
lot.
Question for you is, do you cook or do you cake? Like, what's your go-to thing?
It depends. You know, I'm a moody person. When I'm home, I bake. Okay. Because, you know, I have these documents and I have a lot of help. But when I'm alone, I cook.
And from what I have had conversations with you in the past, you're off gluten.
I'm completely off gluten and sugar. In fact, for 2 years, I was also off dairy. But then because I kind of changed my lifestyle a little, I've kind of incorporated it again. It's just something we keep doing film to film. You have to keep transforming yourself. But gluten is a complete no.
It's a complete no.
It's a complete
and when is this since? Okay, guys.
It's...
Guys, you need to be quiet. Because then only then will you hear it. Okay.
So it has been since my transformation, because I mean, I'm sure people in the audience have watched my film Dabne Vaake Haisha. The ones that haven't, please go watch it, because it truly is a wonderful film. But I gained over 30 kgs for the movie, and once the film released, I had to knock it off because I was going to start another film called Toilet Ek Prem Katha in like very few months. So I changed a lot in my everyday lifestyle, in my everyday being, and that is a combination of, you know, holistically changing the way you think, the way you feel about yourself. Absolutely. You have to love yourself to feel good.
Absolutely.
And to bring about any kind of positive change, right? So I think since Dabne Vaake Haisha, I've knocked off about 38 kgs.
Seriously?
Yeah, that's
like a living person out of
the box. Yeah, because I gained about 30 kilos for the film and then I stopped counting. After the moment I touched 30 kgs, I said, Mimi, there's no point. You know, like now just because there was one dedicated person on set, jiska kaam was only to feed me.
How cute!
I swear, and you know, we were shooting in Rishikesh, and I remember Ayushman would like get a panic attack because he's like, oh my god, I have to carry her at the end of the film, how am I going to do it?
And that was like the cover of the poster.
Yeah, that was the climax of the film, and he shot it for 5 days, and you know, he would literally someone like pull Maggie off me, or like things that I would eat, like different things, because the moment I would not eat, let me put it in a nicer way, things that are very tasty and that like help you gain weight, I would knock off the weight. So for 1 year, I was literally eating and getting paid for it.
Isn't that like the most wonderful thing, guys? Like you're eating, you're getting paid,
yeah.
You're looking glamorous on screen.
Yeah.
Like what else does anyone want out of life? Simple, yeah?
It was such fun. But then after Dabne Vaake Haisha, I was like, you know, it's time to kind of take things into control, and the knocking off the weight was equally tough. Because gaining weight is tough, it's not the easiest thing to do.
And we all have been thinking the reverse, right? We all think...
When you come down to gaining about 30-35 kgs, trust me, it isn't easy. But yeah, it's a lot of fun.
You know, I think we should start mixing it.
Shalji?
Henna?
I cannot wait to have the
brownie. So nice. Cheer it up, because that's our first in public domain.
Yeah, and I'm feeling very pressurized.
So please
don't. I don't know. I don't want to judge my whisking. You are intimidating me.
I'm the last.
The best chef in Asia Pacific is standing next to me, and he's going to teach you the 5-minute brownie.
Literally, sir. Okay.
And I'm going to be eating this every day while I
sleep. Super. First thing is to crack 2 eggs.
Okay.
Okay, it's as simple as literally 2 eggs.
So that's the second one.
Oh yeah. It's already got enough.
Okay.
Oh yeah. That's the first cracked egg. Okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is as simple as pushing every goddamn thing that's on the table into the bowl.
Okay.
Yeah?
That's okay.
Now. That it that is
super.
No.
Elf sugar.
You want to tell them what it is? Do you
so
like use it on a
regular basis? Yeah, I use it because the diet that I'm following doesn't allow any sugar, so this is a sugar substitute. But a better substitute than erythritol would be stevia, because it's more natural, and that's something that I use regularly. And at first it might taste a little weird, but then you get used to it. Stevia is a fantastic sugar substitute because
like kind of putting it to use. And also we get a lot of fake candles. So
okay.
We get a lot of nice candle stuff. So you know, as easy as it looks, trust me, it's easier than
I'm posing.
And we are the kings and queens of fake candles.
I'm
right?
ready.
So yeah. Like, yeah, that's how you like kill it. Okay? Now it doesn't need all of this fancy gadget, so this can go aside.
Okay.
So this is just to kind of for the camera.
For our pictures.
For the picture. Okay. Now what I'm adding to this is of course some cocoa powder.
Yum.
To this. Almond flour. Now this is also known as almond meal.
Yes.
It's as simple as almonds, badam, which is like just run into a mixer. And you can check again. You want it finer, you want it coarser, you want like a mix. Don't keep it extra coarse because that's not going to kind of come together. But the finer the better.
In fact, this is one of my most favorite ingredients. I do almond flour, roti.
Yeah.
It's a part of everything. I use it as a thickening agent in my food. Like, it's just such a versatile ingredient.
Absolutely.
Full of minerals.
One thing that we generically do is add in just like a pinch, literally, of salt.
Why though?
Because in this case, what happens is it just kind of brings out the flavor of almonds. Because almonds otherwise are just neutral in flavor,
right?
Unless and until you kind of eat it for a reason or for a purpose, you can soak it in honey or whatever. But otherwise, it just kind of brings out the flavor, as simple as that. What I did while she was talking, is I just kind of put in some butter, just kind of soften up a little. So this goes in. Okay, you can mix it if you want.
With this?
No. It's just as simple as that. To this, I'm also adding in just half a teaspoon of baking powder. Now this is also to kind of just give it a little bit of a rise. Just light, and that's about it. And to this, I'm adding in vanilla extract, which is, again, personal. To this, you can add in some other essences. You can add raspberries, you can add in hazelnut, you can add in butterscotch. Because essences generally are non-fatty, they're just kind of flavors.
Right.
But however, if you can use something of natural origin, nothing like it. Yeah. So it's all about just mixing it together. That's
it. Am I doing a good job?
You're doing a fantastic job.
Yay! Should we do a few more fake candidates?
We're already there. Okay. So one thing that I've learned from her is always smile.
Always.
At this camera.
Always.
He looks like he's gonna get some brilliant pictures.
He also has my correct profile. I'm sorry guys.
So I don't know if you guys noticed, but as soon as I came in, I just came quietly and stood next to her on the right.
Because I instructed him, I said, Varun, this is just the way it goes. This is just the way it goes.
I just needed that cue, so I just came and stood right. Okay. The next thing that goes in, because I don't know if you can see it closely, but this has kind of become a little wet sand-like. We just need to moisture it up. For that, of course, I am going to use oil. Now, oil is, again, extremely helpful. We all kind of go on a zero oil diet and this and that and blah, 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 blah. But oil, trust me, is extremely important because it just kind of lubricates your body, right? It just keeps it all perfect and going. So I'm just adding in a little bit here.
I'm clearly.
So she's again there.
I feel like a professional cook standing next to you. I've never had ingredients in life.
And we kind of look better on screen because we just say, or it's not here, darling, here, blah, blah.
No.
Kind of.
Come on. Work is work. I think
you know,
we all work hard.
It
all the time.
Yeah. Okay. Now, how do you want it? Do you want it like a shape or you want it like individual? I think individual.
Individual.
So then, yeah.
Oh, wait. Is that?
Yeah. What? It almost finished like moments back. She was just posing to the camera. In case, it was really fast.
Yeah.
So the next thing is, okay. Now, generally when you look at cakes and brownies and raglas and glue, it calls for greasing, it calls for dusting, it calls for a butter paper, this paper, that paper. I wish I was on the camera. Nothing. Yeah. All you need is this batter to go inside that. So this can move aside now because you don't need this literally. There you go. It's super easy, it's super quick, and it's wonderful because it's high on keto. It's just amazing. Okay, now you can fill it a little above 3-4 because it's not going to rise like a hair. Yeah, it's not like a volcano that is going to get up. But what I'm going to do is, okay, just fill this a little more so that it looks prettier on camera. Guys, interesting so far?
Because yeah.
Literally in under 2 minutes, Bhumi has done a brownie.
I love it. Bhumi's brownie. I can't even start a business.
So you know, when I walked in, I just kind of told someone that this is Bhumi, which is Mother Earth, and Varun, which is like a water god.
Oh my god!
Coming together, and we're going to create a blockbuster. Like yeah. Fire the stage up. So like, Ella.
I can't wait.
Ella. Chalo.
It's smelling divine.
It's like, amazing.
I have to smell this.
Okay. There we go. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, goes in precisely for 3 minutes in a microwave. Yeah?
Like your Chef, regular,
can I have you here? Okay.
Your now, regular
you put in one so that you can take the blame if it doesn't come right. You over-mixed it.
Really?
No. Okay. Okay, that goes in there. Shut it.
Yeah. But like a regular microwave setting.
Regular microwave setting.
Excuse me.
Oh, sorry, I forgot. Okay, we make a monster out of this liquid milk, but trust me, it's quite a baby in your kitchen. Because we have a lot of myths revolving around this. We feel cooking in a microwave could be unhealthy.
Right.
We feel it induces cancer. It kind of aggravates your cancerous cells. Electromagnetic waves. It changes the DNA.
Lose radicals in your food.
There is so much about this little baby that we say, ye bachcha achcha nahi. Like, bahut achcha bachcha hai. It does not kind of harm you as much as it used to. More than this, the cell phones in your hands
absolutely
are much, much, much more harmful. So she's already taking it part, right? Chef, 3 minutes here? Yeah, super. So yeah, we just wait till
yeah.
Okay, let's not waste her time. Let's go quick rapid fire.
Rapid fire?
You're used to this?
Where's the couch?
Okay, now whoever, okay, I'll also ask a random question to the audience. Whoever gets that answer right, goes on a dinner date with Bhumi. Okay? But that's not Bhumi painting, okay? Bhumi Gokhale. Bhumi Gokhale. Can you have me here? Where's she?
Good one. I'm like, what? I said, when did we discuss that?
When did that happen? Okay, so very, very, very quickly there. Jalebi versus Moda. What's your pick?
Oh my god, Moda.
What do that?
Moda. Oh my god, that's a tough one.
That's a tough one.
Moda. Yeah. But the Maharashtra will always say Moda.
So this is like painting or an Inam Dal coming here. Okay, samosas or vada pav?
Vada pav.
You're waiting for that, right? You knew
it. Vada pav, Mumbai, matlab.
Okay, now this is going to be very difficult. Tapsi or Anand?
No. I want Kurana.
That's also quite a thing. Okay. Sandhya or Chandra?
Oh no. This is very tough.
It is.
I can't. It's like sitting between my heart and my lungs. Like what organs hold
on.
I can't.
And I somewhere knew that would come.
Oh good one, yeah. Huh?
Okay. What is your go-to comfort food? Like when you just want to laze up in your pajamas, you're watching.
I have a few. I can name all of them. It starts with just dal chawal at home. So there's nothing like homemade food.
You like to pair it with something? Like pickle, papad, chutney?
Pickle, like an aloo ki sabzi. Or like, I love. Actually, the food in the house is very versatile. You know, because my mom's Haryanvi, my father's Maharashtrian, so there's just such a beautiful marriage of cuisines that happens in my house. So there are days that we have poha in the morning, there are days that we have misi roti with lots of like white butter. And unfortunately, I can't eat most of those things, but I have my days. So I think comfort food has to be home food. Like,
dal chawal, can we talk that?
I think.
Okay, so that's screaming potential.
Can you guys smell it?
Okay guys, it's done by the way.
No. Varun, I think Bhumi needs to take this out.
Yeah?
Bhumi, right now, right here, everybody, we're making a blockbuster with Godrej Microwave Oven. Come on, give it up for Bhumi painting for everyone. Work for it. Work for it.
It's sinful, that it's lava,
so
it's just kind
good.
Of looking so beautiful, isn't it?
That looks so good. Maybe very warm.
Why?
I'm worried it's really warm.
It's not very warm. But it's okay, you can take it.
Yeah.
skin fact. I think I saw this.
Henna? Ah, what happened?
No, I can actually.
Why don't
it's just like drooling all over and dropping on the sides. Okay.
And it's smelling divine.
Look at this, guys, and this is fantastic.
Oh my god.
Already looks
and it's
so
like
smells.
Smells.
And the best part is it's very soft within. It's almost like what you hear, like a lava cake.
Yeah.
It's almost like that. It's a self-saucing pudding because you just don't need to do anything. And it's just wonderful. It
smells amazing.
Okay, so here you go, guys.
So is there a way to check if it's all
there
like
is no
inside?
Way. There's only one way. You take
eat
a,
it.
You take a spoon and you just take it. That's the only way. Now,
okay.
You know, you're just wanting to make things look prettier. That's the only way.
Are you going to ice it?
No, we're not ice it because I just don't want that snowy look. I want the nice, gooey looking chocolate to be still seen. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to add in some berries. Now, berries again, oxidants and this and that.
They're
and
the best.
So much about
they're
them.
The they're very low in calories and sugar, the sugar levels in berries are very low. They're just so good.
Also,
it's my go-to food.
Yeah, is it? Also, when you're under ketosis or when you're under a keto diet, there are certain fruits which are not to be eaten.
Yeah.
And there are some fruits that are to be eaten. Avocados, raspberries are one of those that
yeah.
you have to kind of include in your
yeah.
diet. And a lot of berries left. So here,
that's beautiful.
As simple as this. Just another bit here. And yeah, as simple as this, yeah. There you go.
It's ready.
As simple as this. I mean, you just don't need like anything. Yeah. Okay, can we just add in like a which is also kind of not required, but
just
like, because it's there. Because there's a lot of green already because we've not kind of hulled the berry. Yeah, there you go.
Alright.
Super.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's what we baked the blockbuster with Godrej Microwave Ovens. Right here, right now, with the Bhumi Pednekar. Bhumi, this looks like a blockbuster, right? You'd
oh,
like
yes,
to taste
yes.
this?
Oh, I can't wait. And I wish we could share. Oh, yes.
Okay, now whoever wants to take a picture of this, please take it right now.
Do you want to zoom in your cameras to the blockbuster right here?
So I can take one there.
Guys, don't forget to...
go mad and wild.
Don't forget to tag @GodrejLaFair and hashtag start a healthy habit. Alright?
This one?
Oh yeah. I'm easy.
Is that easy?
No,
you're
under
2 minutes.
You want me to hold it? Wait, I'll tell you.
Okay.
It's really hot when it comes. Is this good?
Ice
yeah.
sauce.
Alright, alright. Varun and Bhumi.
Let's do this.
Varun and Bhumi, let's dig in here, guys.
Come on, she can't wait. That's the best.
I already have my spoon ready. Everybody, 3, 2, 1.
Woo! Yeah, guys. That's for all of you. Tumhare naam.
Alright, guys. I've never had.
I think we should just prop her spoon up a little.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just add in some color. Okay. Yeah.
I had something better, Varun. That's brilliant. Yeah. Some juice.
Why should know where you're looking?
This is your food,
everywhere.
Guys. This
everywhere.
Is your food. Don't forget to tag @GodrejLaFair,
okay,
everyone.
I'm gonna go for it.
That's
yeah.
You. And you guys are lucky. Isn't it crazy?
All right, Bhumi. Love it. Love it.
Healthy, simple, easy.
It's outstanding.
Everybody give it up for Varun and Bhumi. Now, this is our first masterclass. Annapurna baking a blockbuster with Bhumi Pednekar and Godrej Microwave Ovens. Now, Varun, you know, one question to you. Generally, I know it's a myth, right, that the food in microwave ovens is a little radioactive and it's not healthy
sure.
and the nutrients go away. Is that true?
It's not really, and I already spoke about that even when we were like kind of cooking and we were mixing a lot of things is, trust me, the cell phone in your hands is much more lethal than this in equipment.
Yeah.
And also, if this is harmful, so is the sun. Yeah, so it's as clean and clear as that. Nevertheless, you say it changes the DNA of the water and this and that and blah, 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 blah. All fake. There are a lot of studies that say it's all fake.
Yeah.
It's a myth that has been carried over and over and over and over and over years and decades.
In fact, my bread, etc., because I'm constantly traveling, right? I don't always have access to like gluten-free bread or bread that or bread that's keto-friendly. And most of my baking happens in my microwave.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, most of it. I think it's just such a handy equipment. I actually travel with one. I travel with a small little kitchen everywhere I go. So it has a microwave. It had a fridge, but not anymore because I started shifting in slightly urban cities earlier. They were like digital villages. So I also gone a step further, so there's no fridge. But I have.
I don't want to visit you on your sets.
It's great
fun. Because you will say, beta, tum khana bana. Milna milna bol gaya, ab tum kuch khilao.
100%. All right. So there's a myth, guys. It's completely healthy cooking. Cottage microwave ovens. And now is the time for the two big winners of the Start a Healthy Habit with Bhumi Pednekar. I have the names right here, right now with me, and I'm going to announce them. We have two hampers being given out by Bhumi herself. Two, can you all give it up for Sunny Rampal? Are you here with us, Sunny? And with this, everyone, we...
Okay, Bhumi, first of all, you're looking very, very pretty.
Thank you.
So how was the session and also the new Bhumi brownie?
The Bhumi brownie, I think I'm looking really nice because the food is something that makes me really happy. Like, it makes everybody happy. And we had such a fun cooking session. You know, they say cooking is therapeutic. And I think I've had a small little therapy session right now inside. And we made the Bhumi brownie with ingredients that kind of fit my lifestyle and my diet. And it was so tasty. Honestly, I wanted to go for another bite, but I said, you know, Bhumi, maybe not in front of many people, but it was so good. Chef Varun is just, he is one of the best, like, chefs, especially in Asia Pacific, and he's just such good energy. It was conversational, we spoke, we chatted, and for the love of food, there's a huge smile on my face.
Okay,
I think everybody knows I'm a very big foodie. Food is actually something, it makes you happy, it gives you comfort. Food has a very big it plays a very big aspect in my everyday life, because you know, it's just not about indulging, it is also about eating right. You know, I can literally feel the difference on days that I indulge and the days I'm eating clean, because you know, just eating right, eating a correct proportion can really have a huge effect on your day. So yeah, food, a lot of my schedule is planned around my meals, so that's how important food is in my life.
Okay, also, Bhumi ma'am, you are also a role model for many people. You have become a first back to fit. So, how tough was it for any mantra you like to share?
No, it is tough. You know, it's not easy when you go through such a big transformation. But I think even gaining the weight is equally tough. But some things that I followed when I was knocking off my weight after Dam Laga Ke Hai Sha was just, you know, I gave up a lot of things like refined sugar. I wasn't eating any gluten, eating right portions, eating on time, like not eating post 7 o'clock in the evening, were small little things that really helped me. Just being aware of what's going into my body and the effect it's going to have on my body is something that really helped me knock off the weight. मैं सच बताऊं, मैंने फर्स्ट टाइम कब कुक किया था. एक्चुअली एक बार ना मैं स्कूल में थी तब मैंने अपने पेरेंट्स के लिए केक बेक करने की कोशिश की थी, बहुत बड़ा एपिक फेल था वो. लेकिन उसके बाद व्हेन आई एक्चुअली फर्स्ट टाइम एक्टिवली कुकिंग करी वो थी सोन चिड़िया के दौरान. तो मैं उस फिल्म के वक्त पूरा मैंने खाना बनाना सीखा था बिकॉज मेरे कैरेक्टर डेवलपमेंट का वो हिस्सा था. तो मैं जब भी किचन में एक्चुअली घुसती हूँ वो सिर्फ मेरे कैरेक्टर प्रेप के लिए घुसती हूँ, वरना मुझे खाने का शौक है और रिसेंटली पकाने का भी खाना. Because it was a special appearance in both the films. Shubh Mangal Zyada Saavdhan, Shubh Mangal Saavdhan ka franchise hai. Jo director hai, wo Shubh Mangal Saavdhan ke writer hai chuke hai. And he's somebody who's a very dear friend. And you know, obviously it's my film's franchise. So I had to do something in it. And everybody knows what the story is. Toh mera Shubh Mangal Zyada Saavdhan mein main kuch nahi kar sakti thi. And where Bhoot is concerned, the team, they are very close to me. In fact, the director is one of my oldest friends. And I just wanted to be a part of his first film. And that's why I did this friendly appearance in the film. And I'm very happy that both the films are getting love and they are doing whatever they are doing. And I'm glad that my audiences are missing me because I also miss them. I miss seeing their reaction. And but I'm going to be back now only. क्या बताऊँ मैं तख्त के बारे में, बहुत एक्साइटेड हूँ. लिटरली मेरा ड्रीम प्रोजेक्ट है तख्त. करण के साथ काम करना आई थिंक किसी भी एक्टर के बकेट लिस्ट में होता है. सो आई फील वेरी वेरी फॉर्चुनेट. एंड मेरी तीसरी कोलैबोरेशन होगी ये धर्मा के साथ. एंड या आई कांट वेट टू स्टार्ट. इट्स अ वेरी स्पेशल फिल्म फॉर एवरीबडी हु इज़ इन द कास्ट एंड अदरवाइज ऑल्सो.